I think, the focus that they started out with, which is to be about video games. I think also some of these channels in the past have focused exclusively on hardcore gamers. And if you do that, you're really only focusing on a very, very narrow population of gamers, and you risk not having a viable commercial proposition. So they never really made it to the promised land. But Jinx has got a better map, a better sense of direction, better equipment, and frankly, a much better team. That is the main reason why I think Jinx TV is going to work where others haven't. It's essentially a TV proposition, and we're essentially TV people. We bring a perspective which is all about the viewer. One of the biggest messages I had to get across at MTV is to make the creators make shows for the audience rather than making audience shows for themselves that they thought was cool, because they would be far, far ahead of the audience. Yes, most of the team at Jinx are fervent gamers, and we have a real depth of knowledge about games, goes without saying, and we have a real personal engagement with video gaming. But first and foremost, we come at this from a TV experience. Like our chairman, Peter Einstein, formerly CEO of Showtime Arabia and at MTV, myself with over 20 years of experience in the industry, and Udi Shapira, who's over there, our creative director, with extensive TV experience in Nickelodeon. We are all passionately focused on what will work from a TV perspective. So that entails great creativity in the way we script, we shoot, and we edit shows, and create the interstitials. It's about the way we audition and scout for new presenters and rising talents. In my past, I have seen VHSs of Cat Deeley. Davina McCall was a receptionist at MTV. Russell Brand came in at the early stages of his career. And we have nurtured these people for a time, and then they pass on to the big terrestrial networks. It's a strategy that we will follow with Jinx. TV is also about research. You can't hope to succeed without it. Some of our predecessors might have tried to do so. As you've already seen at Jinx, we are research-centric. It's not just a one-off, but it's an ongoing part of our business, a constant attempt to understand who our audiences are, exactly what they want. You've got to fish in the pond, basically, where the fish are. Don't go ignoring audiences that do exist, and giving content to audiences who don't exist. So for us, it's about light gamers and engaged gamers. They are out there, they might not be the coolest, but they certainly play games, and we need to bring them in the fold of around the hardcore center of our channel. We tend to analyze everything, stripping the day into segments or day parts, targeting our resources to build a channel which is in effect a multi-audience channel. This can mean different programming at even a different brand feel in different and different audiences at different times of the day and the week. We are going to develop a winning digital TV channel, and we're talking specifically about digital TV. And that's another possible point of difference with what's gone before. Professionally at Jinx, we've all grown up with digital TV, which is not the same as terrestrial television, which still commands the majority of viewers, although just. Digital TV is a very special beast. It has to be incredibly cunning and resourceful. We have to run on budgets that terrestrial TV couldn't survive on. It's no accident that miracle on a shoestring is one of my favorite creative mantras. I think creatives work better when strapped for cash rather than lavished with cash. And yet digital TV is incredibly fertile, with a great fondness for propagating itself. Before joining Jinx, for example, I oversaw the launch of no less than 26 channels and presided over several other non-music channels, such as the children's channel Nickelodeon and Paramount Comedy. Launching a successful digital channel is an art and a science which only experience really can help you master. A final differentiator of Jinx is our worldwide ambitions. Yes, we do want to take over the world, at least in TV terms. Though that's driven by cool business logic rather than ego, hopefully, anyway. We're creating uniquely formatted shows which can be localized at minimum cost, making it far easier to distribute programming and set up local channels. Our philosophy of programming is geared towards this. The result is that we expect that within 2 years, we will be available in over 30 countries. We've already made a start with successful 24/7 channels in Indonesia and Turkey. And our programming is available in South Africa, the UK, Spain, Germany, amongst other markets. Territories in Western and Eastern Europe, Latin America, North America, Asia, Africa, Australia, New Zealand will follow fast over the next 24 months. Contrast this with the first wave of channel rollouts, which took the best part of 10 years to reach those 30 countries. And you can see how not only digital technology, but also other changes have transformed the global TV industry. But also the importance of knowing exactly what your business and marketing strategy is from the word go. Being available in 30 countries, reaching the vast majority of 400 million global gamers, a number which we consider an underestimate, by the way, the possibilities for connecting to different audiences, understanding their needs, creating cross-country forums for promoting new interest, this is all part of the Jinx recipe for must-watch television. I also believe that we will create a huge potential for you in the industry to connect directly with your audiences through creative and commercial collaboration. This is another possible contrast with the music industry. The music industry is part, as many of you know, is going through a very difficult time as the basic technology of consumption is changing. In a sense, music videos created huge new audiences for some acts, but also offer an alternative standalone form of consumption. Watching a Katy Perry or R.E.M. music video, or even my old dance buddy Justin Timberlake, might encourage you to buy a track or even the album, but equally, you might feel that watching the video itself is enough. I can't see that happening with Jinx. Video gaming TV will always be a gateway to the real experience of playing games, rather than an end in itself. With your help, we'll present those games in the most compelling of ways. We'll explore the rich cultural content around them, present all the latest news, and look at new ways of stimulating and satisfying interest around those games. But we can never be a substitute for gameplay itself. So, if the time is right for video gaming television, what are we going to do about it? Launch a channel, of course. I am now delighted to be able to announce to you publicly for the first time that in November of this year we will be launching Jinx TV as a full channel in the UK. It will be the UK's only 24-hour channel totally dedicated to gaming. We are looking at distribution in high definition and possibly 3D as well as standard definition. Our aim is to have our channel fully distributed on both cable and satellite TV households. Allow me to give you a sneak preview of what it's going to look like. I'll make an apology for some elements of the tape. For the knowing under you, they're clearly audition tapes for people that we're testing out for the channel. So it's a little rough in edges, but it will give you a flavor. Please roll the DVD, thank you.
I'm not smurf, okay? I'm clearly not smurf. on the sun
itself. Step off the little kind of dots and bricks and shrubs.
Yeah, and just live.
Revenge of the Gamers!
Your 30 seconds to answer each question for satisfaction. Any failed answers will incur the wrath of the Avenger. Question 1. Many gamers were outraged at the inclusion of the airport scene. Was this just cheap publicity seeking, or was there really a deeper meaning?
It's actually a new test character.
Fail.
I hope that gives you a little flavor. We will start quite powerfully, straight out of the box, and we will go on from there. To begin with, we will predominantly focus on brilliant games reviews, presented creatively, original, and compelling formats, and eye-catching graphics. From the outset, everything we do will have a strong, distinct brand identity, which immediately marks us as something special. From there, we'll bring on other shows that tap into the rich culture of video gaming. For example, we're looking at shows on sport that highlight the incredible passion many sports people have for gaming. We all know that the Wayne Rooneys and John Terrys of this world play as much video gaming as they do real games. Another logical link is between music and games. Our show Tour Bus will follow bands and explore the games they play whilst on the road. We want to do something with army personnel and real warfare, and daytime TV could be the place about new puzzle games to tap into that huge market for the light gaming audience segment. The list goes on. The Jinx Channel is going to be an evolution rather than an overnight revolution. And that's exactly how great TV tends to develop. Long before MTV went on to make films, reality TV shows, and host the huge award ceremonies that I talked about earlier on, it started with simple back-to-back music videos, and that's the last MTV reference, I promise. It's now all about Jinx. I just want to say, in conclusion, TV is essentially a collaborative venture. Any TV program involves dozens of different types of contribution, whether it's creative or technical or support. For Jinx, collaboration with the video gaming industry has to be at the very heart of what we do. So I'd really like to hear any questions or comments you have, not only now, but also in the rest of the day, and indeed from now on. My email address is at the bottom of the screen. I'd love to hear from you if you don't hear from me first. Jinx can be great for us, and it can be great for you. The dialogue starts now. After all, I hope you'll agree the time is right. Thank you.
To my stuff you saw yesterday. I think what's good for you is clearly good for everyone in this room, and we'd all wish you well. We're also delighted you'd announce something this important at this festival. I was wondering, do you think there's any scope for a hybrid sort of thing that is halfway between a television program and a game and includes elements of both? It's a loaded question because I'm going to suggest that there is tomorrow's at the television festival, but I wondered if you thought it was possible and what the ramifications of it would be.
It's a really interesting question, and one that has been played out at Jinx quite a bit. Hybrid means two things. It means a coming together of the two platforms, if you will, gaming and TV in one creative concept. So either you make that TV-centric. And one of the thoughts you can have is you make it TV-centric and you allow the interactive engines behind TV